Today I'll bring you in another island of the Mediterranean basin. Today we talk about Sardinia. And Sardinia means, for those who have a little confidence with polyphonic singing, means an island full of polyphonic singing traditions. Not everyone has to know it. So I'd like to spend a few seconds, few words about this big basin of voices that we find in Sardinia, and then we are going to focus especially in the small town and area of Orosei, so in the east center coast of the island. In all Sardinia, it's very well known the tradition of so-called canto a tenore, singing a tenore. And here we have to make a little attention, because when we say a tenore, it's an international word and it's connected with opera singing and can lead us in the wrong direction, so we have to break the horse. A tenore in this case, in Sardinia, it means simply to sing. We take the word tenore from the Latin word a tenorem, that means simply to hold something in a dense and stable way. This is the etymological meaning in the Latin word of tenore, a tenorem, as they were saying. And the canto a tenore is exactly like this. It's a way of singing that requires four voices. And this is important to underline, because we spoke in other episodes already about Corsican voices, where mostly we found the presence of three voices only. In this case, the voices are four, and they are called also in a way that is different from other islands. They call themselves bass, okay, the bassu. They call themselves contralt, from contralto, but in fact it has also the meaning of being against, or against an harmony, creating some, giving some spice to the harmony that is created by the voices. The voce, meaning guos, voice itself, that is the leading part of the polyphony. And the top voice, that is called, actually in Sardinia, in the canto a tenore, is called mezzo voce, half voice, that in fact is the top voice of this quartet of voices. And when we go and focus on Orosei, we're going to meet extraordinary singers and a very unique situation for Sardinia, because we are in front of singers, four of them, that they are a part of a group that is called Concordu de Orosei, and they have an experience of singing of at least, at the moment, 35 years. And why it's so specific? Because they sing both all the repertoire of the canto a tenore that is common in all Sardinia, and they sing also all the repertoire of the canto a concordu. That is, in the word concordu, again, I need a few seconds, because etymologically it's interesting. We can feel immediately concordo, there is the word cord inside. In Italian it's even easier to arrive to understand, but it means just in harmony, not in a strict musical sense, in harmony of intention, in harmony of voices, in harmony, a concordo. And we name this group, they are named Su Concordu de Orosei, the harmony of Orosei. And it's just these four people. There is Martino Corimbi that is singing the contra. This Giovanni Rosu, Francesco Sannai, Paolo Burrai, mezzovoce. These four people that, like comedians of Commedia dell'arte, all their lives brings the same character into the on the stage while they sing. When we say concordu, what does it mean singing a concordu? A tenore is a way of singing that it's mostly focused on the secular repertoire. When we mean concordu, we are talking about a religious repertoire. With the Concordu de Orosei, we are in front of performers and singers and voices of a very, very high level and of a repertoire very, very, very wide.
Pamiętam naszą nie pierwszą, ale drugą wyprawę na Sardynię i właśnie wizytę w Orosei. Wiedzieliśmy już wtedy, że no właśnie grupa śpiewająca jest niezwykle doświadczona, że to jest ponad wtedy ćwierć wieku. I wtedy zostaliśmy zaproszeni do oratorium, tak? I Martino otworzył przed nami drzwi i zaśpiewali jeden z hymnów, właśnie Kuntempla, który potem stał się częścią naszego spektaklu. Absolutnie uderzyło, absolutnie owładnęło, dlatego poprosiłem Teatr, wszystkich nas, żebyśmy zaśpiewali tylko dwie rzeczy i od razu to były rzeczy dość unikalne, bo my no, nie wozimy pieśni, tak? Nie dealerujemy muzyką, ale poprosiłem, musimy zaśpiewać Zar. Wszyscy byli zdziwieni, mam na myśli grupę teatru, dlaczego śpiewam? Tak, musimy zaśpiewać Zar, musimy od razu jakby postawić kwestię bardzo jasno i bardzo wysoko. Kiedy zaśpiewaliśmy Zar tam w oratorium Świętego Krzyża, Martino bez słowa zaprosił nas do zakrystii, poczęstował czerwonym winem i od razu byliśmy przyjaciółmi bez słowa. Tak jakbyśmy przedstawili się wzajemnie, po prostu tylko dźwiękiem, a przede wszystkim podejściem do głosu. I wcale tutaj nie chodziło o muzyczną staranność, o muzyczną poprawność, tylko o zwykłe ludzkie powinowactwo, które przez muzykę się przedstawiło. I tak w 2006 roku, później w 2007 poznaliśmy się.
Kuntempla that actually has been, let's say, created exactly in this very oratorium of the Church of the Holy Cross and from the singers of this confraternity. It's still sung in the same oratorium but the same people another important thing that they are kind of group that is internationally performing in very important festivals, and they have the chance also to choose where not to go, because they don't do it for money, of course, but they do it to bring these traditions in the right contexts. And they had the chance to work with the many important musicologists and even technicians of the sound that made them build this CD that from which we took the title of these episodes, Sas Animas, that in Sardinian it means the souls. And it's available and free to be listened on YouTube. So if you write Sas Animas Concordo de Orosei, you can find the two CDs, one with all the repertoire of A Concordo and one with all the repertoire A Tenore.